Hello everyone, a very happy 2018 to you. I myself am very excited about this year, so would you guys also be there. The excitement is because 2018 is a harbinger of good news, whether it is your health, whether it is your wealth, or whether it is your prosperity. But what is more important in your life is the wisdom that you apply of the astrological predictions to your life. As you all must have realized by now, that I believe in helping people create their own prophecies rather than live predictions. Now, I want to clarify before I start with the monthly predictions this year. I want you all to understand that the predictions that I do or the things that I write, I give you all as guidelines to follow, and when you apply those guidelines to your life is what makes you healthy, wealthy and wise. My predictions are based on the solar as well as the lunar calculations, but at times we work with our intuitions also, that what is the best for every zodiac or what is the best for you guys out there. Now you must, while understanding these predictions or while adhering to these predictions, listen to the zodiac sign in which your solar energy is. That means which is your sign, whether it is a Capricorn or whether it is an Aries or Taurus or Geminis, etc. Now, then you must also listen carefully to the zodiac in which your moon is placed. Having got your personalized charts made, you all would be definitely aware of where is your sun and where is your moon placed. Like when I'm giving my own calculations to my clients, I not only give them what is expected of them, whether it is their destiny or talents, I also help them know where is the sun placed, where is your moon placed, and where are the other planets placed in your zodiac, and how you need to follow them. How you need to understand that if a particular planet is in a particular sign, what does it do to an individual? I am sure you all will understand now that while listening to my predictions, you must carefully adhere to the zodiac sign in which your sun is placed, and also adhere to the sign in which your moon is placed, because my guidelines for you are based on both the sun and the moon placements. I hope that will be clear to you and it will be much helpful. Pisces, the January and February 2018 for you, which I have clubbed because you must have gone through your yearly chart. Now, January marks a very passive period for you. Destiny favors you after the 17th of January till the end of February, and you may experience low levels of energy, so you're advised to procrastinate any important matters for a better time, that is after February. These 2 months, that is January and February, you might face setbacks, thus be careful. Stomach related problems can surface because of the churning and your stress levels, which can affect your digestive system. Now, people who are working for the government and those engaged in their father's business will definitely perform well. Private job workers may see some disappointments on the career front. Some hardships are widely indicated. Later stages of this month brings very, very productive and fruitful results for you. Sources of income may increase in the month of February. You'll be inclined to mystic and occultic sciences. Only slight chances of pilgrimage can be foreseen for you. But at the same time, if you do a pilgrimage of your inner self and you take time out for yourself and decide what you want to achieve, how you're going to achieve in 2018, I think you should start implementing those suggestions and ideas of yours from March onwards, so that by your birthday in 2019, you're able to at least achieve 80% of the things that you have done. So make a checklist for you now, execute it after February, and see the results for yourself in the coming months. What does your career say? Well, January and February for your career largely depends on the nature of work you are involved in. in general, the period till 13th of February is likely to see some slowness of some kind in your work. But should you give it up, my answer would be no. Government job workers see a good time and bright financial gains. Private job workers are likely to face some difficulties, but if you are resilient and determined, you will overcome them very easily. Job change will not help if work environment becomes too uncomfortable. You need to probably restructure your own self, restructure your strategies, and probably a change of attitude will help. Relations with colleagues and bosses, if you feel they are strained, so it the onus lies on you how to rectify them. Either you rectify them or concentrate on your work and ignore people who can actually put a spoke in your wheel. The work environment appears to be stressful, but it's all on the surface. It actually may not be so. You don't have to think about the salary hike. You have to think how much benefit you have brought to the company and probably state that fact to the authorities concerned, and you will soon see how you establish yourself firmly, securely in the present environment. Because during the end of February, the gains from your hard work is seen, and if you're in a private business, chances are you will gain very profitably, and your business partners will not let you down. You will get proper support. If you're working for somebody, you will get support from your family too, and this proves to be beneficial. So what is the advice for you? Even though if you feel it's a disturbed period for career, it might create you mental stress and could even take a toll on your health. But it is up to your mental stamina or how resilient or determined you are in regards to your work is what is going to be the results in these preceding months of January and February. But if you're resilient now in January and February, and if you're determined and if you restructure yourself, rest assured the coming months are going to be working in your favor. So it's important for you to do your work with a passion, and money will automatically follow. And ensure that you are materialistic, but not with an arrogance. You definitely need to visualize what is the kind of money that you want and be realistic about it. So what do we talk about your relationships? Since money is going to be a little constrained, so how is the honey going to follow? Well, in January and February, love and marriage brings along a term with mixed flavors. Your relationship with the existing partner will be mostly on a positive state during the initial stages of February. That means till the first half of February, after which whatever differences crop up have to be sorted out amicably, or you could find some mental strain. So anything happening where love and romance is concerned, even if it is scanty, it's bound to be solid. Now for singles, it is not a suitable period in these 2 months to get into any kind of love partnership, as chances of deception are very high, so you should be careful. And progeny aspects are very positively denoted, so care has to be taken, and make sure that you do not neglect your partner. What does money and finance say? Well, January and February, finances indicate a picture of prosperity. Good financial gains are being denoted in spite of the career dilemma or the financial dilemma that I've spoken to earlier. So overall, on an average, you are going to be satisfied with whatever you do, and you have to learn to be satisfied with whatever you earn, because whatever you earn is completely in relationship with whatever you learn. So your input is what will decide your output. So you are likely to have power, resources and material achievements. You may acquire some unexpected wealth. Trading and stock market and any investments best be avoided, especially if you're not sure of. Don't indulge in a whim or don't indulge in a hearsay. Expenses are expected to be there, but if you can control them, that will work in your advantage. Growth in the number of sources of income is highly indicated. That means there are chances that you may get income from various sources in your bucket. So what is important where your health is concerned, for the health, for the Pisces in January and February, it shows a bumpy kind of a ride. So you may undergo or face some stomach related issues. You should be careful about what you eat, what you drink, and are the sources from where you're having or where you're having hygienic enough. Ache in back and thighs due to a change in season, that means climatic season is highlighted. Medical help should be taken and carelessness should be avoided. Your domestic environment remains average with a good understanding, and bonding is indicated during the initial stages of January and February, followed by minor arguments in the latter half. But the minor arguments are completely in correlation with your finances. So if your finances are sorted, your honey is automatically sorted. And in January and February, you have to only restructure yourself, see what is not working, eliminate the negatives from your life. A change of attitude, concentration and focus will do you a lot of good. And as usual, for your best days, your money days, your honey days, your career days, and the days that you need to avoid doing anything important, please visit my website. And for knowing where your sun is based or where your moon, natal moon is based, it'll be a good idea if you can get your natal and personalized charts made.